गुड मॉर्निंग, मैं सर डॉक्टर मृणाल लाकरे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ द्रव्यगुण, ग्लोबल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ आयुर्वेदा. इन आवर फार्माकोलॉजिकल सीरीज नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज हिपैटोप्रोटेक्टिव ड्रग्स. नाउ व्हाट आर हिपैटोप्रोटेक्टिव ड्रग्स? तो हिपैटोप्रोटेक्टिव ड्रग्स आर द ड्रग्स दैट आर यूज इन केस ऑफ हिपैटोटॉक्सिसिटी और इन एनी केस विच हैज कॉज्ड लीवर डैमेज. इन दैट केस वी यूज हिपैटोप्रोटेक्टिव ड्रग्स. और एनी इन्फेक्शन दैट कॉज टू लीवर, इन दैट केस वी यूज हिपैटोप्रोटेक्टिव ड्रग्स. नाउ इफ वी सी लीवर, लीवर इज वन ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट ऑर्गन इन योर ह्यूमन बॉडी एंड इट इज अ चीफ ऑर्गन विच इज इंटेंस. इट्स इंटेंस एक्शन इज टू हैव मेटाबोलिज्म एंड एक्सक्रीशन. Also, it has some roles in hemostasis and maintenance and performance and regulation of hemostasis in body. Also, it involves in biochemical pathway to growth, fight against diseases, nutrient supply to all organs, other organs of the body, energy provisions and reproduction. In many cases, it is used for means liver has its own action, its own biochemical pathway for growth of the human being. If any person, any child who is having his liver not very well developed or liver is insufficient to perform his activity, then that child won't have its proper growth. Even that child won't be, or that person, it will always be prone to many infectious diseases or many diseases, because many antibiotics and many antibodies and many such antibodies are prepared in liver. Now this is our function of liver. Means if we see there are many function of liver. First, it is secretory. Bile acid, it is secreted from cholesterol, and it also does the conjugation of bilirubin. And excretory, many exogenous dyes are excreted from liver. Then metabolic, in liver, carbohydrate, lipid, amino acids, mineral, vitamin, nucleic acid are metabolized. Then there is synthesis and esterification of cholesterol is there. Due to that esterification and synthesis of cholesterol, bile acid is also secreted. Ammonia formation, then interconversion of sugar, it is done in liver. Now next is synthesis. Albumin, alpha 1 and gamma 2 globulin are synthesized in liver. Then clotting factor, many clotting factor, they are synthesized in liver. Binding proteins, which are helpful in binding of many enzymes, it is also synthesized in liver. Transport proteins, the proteins which are responsible for transportation of gases, nutrients and other things in body are secreted from or synthesized from liver. Then detoxification. This detoxification, it is a major role of liver. It detoxifies whole body, all the toxins in the body, in sera, in blood, they are detoxified by the liver. This generally detoxification is done by xenobiotics, steroids, thyroid hormones and endogenous metabolites. From this, whole body is detoxified. Then storage. Liver also performs as a storage organ. In liver, glycogen, vitamin B12 and vitamin A, these are stored in liver as a storehouse. And after, whenever the body feels lack of vitamin B12, if we don't get supplement from outside or in our food of vitamin B12 and vitamin A, then this liver, it released whole vitamin A and vitamin B12. Also glycogen is also stored in liver. Now liver toxicity, when we see about the hepatotoxic drug, so in before that we should know what is liver toxicity and why we should use hepatoprotective drugs. So liver toxicity main means when there is a damage to liver, then we can say it as a liver, it is liver toxicity. Majorly in India, alcohol is the main responsible source for liver damage, that is ethanol, methanol. Many alcoholic person, they have their liver hepatotoxicity is done by the alcohol, or the liver damage is done by alcohol. Chemicals like carbon tetrachloride, then phosphorus, aflatoxins, chlorinated hydrocarbons, they also has liver toxic effect. Carbon tetrachloride, aflatoxin. Aflatoxins are present in many foodstuffs like peanuts, the products which are under the ground like potatoes, peanuts, they contain an aflatoxins. These aflatoxins, they cause liver damage. Drugs, drug causing DILI. DILI means drugs induced liver injury. Many drugs are there, they cause liver damage like onco drugs, then higher end antibiotics, many steroids, they cause liver damage. Autoimmune disorders, some autoimmune disorders, they also cause liver damage. Infections, now infections like viral hepatitis, hepatitis A, B, they causes liver toxicity or liver damage. Now these are the list of DILI, drug-induced liver injury, that is anti-tubercular drugs. All anti-tubercular drugs except ethambutol, they have hepatotoxicity. Then anticonvulsant drugs. Anticonvulsant drugs like carbamazine and valproic acid, they have hepatotoxic effect. NSAIDs. NSAIDs, paracetamol, diclofenac, indomethacin, oxycam group, like paroxicam, they have hepatotoxic effect. Antimicrobial drugs like sulfonamides, retrovirals, ketoconazole, dapsone, they have DILI effect or drug-induced liver injury. Anesthetics like enfluran and isoflurane, these both, if they are given in intravenous supply, then it may cause liver hepatotoxicity. Miscellaneous drugs like disulfiram, flutanamide, satin group, labetol, nicotinic acid, propyl thiouracil, and oral contraceptive pills, they also cause hepatotoxicity. Now, acute hepatocellular injury by drug is characterized, means how we can identify that someone body, the patient body has undergone hepatotoxicity. So there are some characterized features like by drug, if we see by drug, there are marked elevation of ALT and AST, then normal or minimal elevated alkaline phosphate, then bilirubin is increased, and worse prognosis is bilirubin, increased bilirubin. Many a times if we see in patients increased bilirubin, without any cause, then it may be due to any drug used in past before 15 days or before 1 month. And then acute hepatocellular injury is caused by alcohol. If it is caused by alcohol, then there may be AST and ALT raised, but in case of alcohol, AST will always be 2 or 3 times higher than ALT. AST will remain below than 300 IU, and ALT will always less than 100 IU. Then there will be towering elevation of ALT and AST. Drugs like acetaminophen, then chemical toxins, mushrooms which are used in food, liver shock, unusual cause of liver disease including viral hepatitis, these all will cause acute hepatocellular injury. Now, mechanism of hepatotoxicity, how hepatotoxicity happens. Most of chemicals, means the drugs which are having chemicals, they damage liver cells mainly by oxidation and having oxidative damage in liver by lipid peroxidation. then some drugs they will reactive to free oxygen radicals and directly induce hepatotoxicity. Some will increase apoptosis and some will reduce glutathione stores and antioxidant on human body. Glutathione, it is a main enzyme that causes oxidation or that act as an antioxidant agent in liver that will protect liver from many diseases. Now, hepatoprotective agents. Many hepatoprotective agents are there, like N-acetylcysteine vitamin, penicillamine, antioxidant melatonin, vitamins melatonin, glutathione, beta-carotene, and many more. Cardiotropin, I-glutathione, herbal medications, beta-carotene, and S-adenosylmethathione, that is known as SAM. These all are used as hepatoprotective agents or hepatoprotective drugs. N-acetylcysteine. Now, what is N-acetylcysteine? It is a derivative of lysine. Pharmacological categories, and it is antidote and mucolytic agent. It is used FDA labeled indications are acetaminophen overdose, if anyone is having acetaminophen overdose, or adjunctive mucolytic therapy, diagnostic bronchial studies. In these cases, it is used. Off-label used are prevention of contrast-induced nephrotoxicity and Helicobacter pylori infection. Generally, in most of the medicine books, if we see N-acetylcysteine, it is used in acetaminophen overdose and mucolytic therapy or bronchial studies. But it has its effect on nephrotoxicity and H. pylori infection. The mechanism of action of N-acetylcysteine, it prevents hepatic injury by restoring hepatic glutathione. It starts restoring hepatic glutathione, and then afterward it improves hemodynamics and oxygen usage. So all the liver cell, it will repaired, and they will use oxygen and hemodynamic, their use of oxygen will be improved. It will decrease cerebral edema. Sometime it may scavenge free radicals and changes hepatic blood flow also. So due to that change in hepatic blood flow, there will be improved in liver damage, or liver damage will be decreased. Some ADR are noted due to N-acetylcysteine. They are in oral ADR. Drowsiness, if N-acetylcysteine is used in oral form, then it will cause drowsiness, fever with chills, nausea, vomiting, bronchospasm, rhinorrhea, unpleasant odor in mouth or in sweating. If it is used in IV form, then it has minimal side effect, anaphylactoid reaction and vomiting. Next is penicillamine. Penicillamine is a degradation product of penicillin, which is used as in past days it was used as antimicrobial, but now it is used as an hepatoprotective agent. Mechanism of action of penicillamine is it chelates several metals like copper, lead, iron and mercury. Then it forms a stable water soluble complex which are excreted through urine. Means many metals like copper, lead, iron and mercury, which are injected in the body, they are chelates by penicillamine, and then they will excrete it through urine. It also combines chemically with cysteine to form a stable, soluble, readily excreted complex. Many that agent that cause toxicity in the body, they can be combined with cysteine and penicillamine to form a complex that can be excreted to urine or fecus. It also have antifibrotic effect that inhibits lysyl oxidase, and enzyme increases collagen production. Generally It is it act as an antifibrotic agent. The whenever the alcohol or any drug that causes a liver fibrosis, it will protect liver from fibrosis. And it converts collagen fibril into collagen fibers. Then that fibers this will be helpful to prevent from liver fibrosis. Also, it acts and penicillamine acts an in immunomodulatory effect that IgM reduce IgM in rheumatoid factor or rheumatoid arthritis. Now SAM. SAM means S-adenosyl-methionine. This methionine, it is an essential amino acid that is primarily metabolized in liver. It is useful amino acid for many liver function to have their proper functions. SAM biosynthesis in the first step in methionine metabolism in a reaction catalyzed by methionine. Then it in mammals, mostly in mammals, liver catabolized half of daily intake of methionine. The liver is the main source of SAM biosynthesis and metabolism, turning over nearly 8 grams per day in normal adults. It is used in transmethylation reaction that converts to S-adenosylmycosystine, that is SAH. SAM is the principal biological methyl donor required for methylation of DNA, RNA, biogenic amines, phospholipid, histones and other proteins. It is the precursor or for synthesis of polyamines, which are required for cell proliferation and maintenance of cell viability. In the liver, SAM is a precursor for glutathione, a major endogenous antioxidant that protects cell against injury by scavenging free radicals. SAM deficiency can impair many vital functions of liver, which render it susceptible to injury by toxic agent, including alcohol. Now, many herbal medications are used by all doctors, mostly for liver tonic or for reducing hepatotoxicity or as an hepatoprotective agent. Many herbal preparations are on table of each and every doctors, and they are their first drug of choice, like Silbum marinum, then Eclipta alba, Forniculum vergale, Trigonilia fionum, Jatropha carcass, Garcinia mangostana, and Chamomile capitale. These are some drugs, but there are list of drugs that can be used. In our science Ayurveda, we have many drugs like Sharpunkha, Bhumi Amalki, Amalki, Trivrutta, many Pitta Virechak drugs. They can be used as hepatoprotective agents. All these hepatoprotective agents, they stimulate of protein synthesis and they repair at the cellular level. They have antioxidant properties also. They prevent transfer of electron from O2 to organic molecule. They have stabilized free radicals, terminates free radical reaction also. So these all are about the hepatoprotective drugs. In next session we will see about some preparations of hepatoprotective drugs from Ayurveda.